Sometimes you try, you think that you know something, and then you try to help someone, and then you go to study, and you realize that you don't know anything, and you need to keep studying, keeping knowing different things, and this is the challenge.
Hey there, it's Jay Kalee, aka The Strength Architect, and 7 years ago, I quit my cushy federal job, and I risked everything and moved down here to beautiful Cancun, Mexico. And within that time, I've had 3 super successful fitness businesses, and I've got to travel the world. Along the way, I've had this awesome opportunity to meet some amazing coaches and to hear their stories, their struggles, and their joys of doing what they do now, living their dream, being a fitness coach. This is for those personal trainers out there who are tired of being stuck in the gym, or for anybody else who is tired of being confined to just their four walls and want to step out into the unknown and finally achieve their dream. This is for you. You're going to hear some amazing stories, all the way from Paris, France, to Istanbul, Turkey, from Berlin, Germany, all the way down to Barcelona, Spain. I'm telling you, these stories are going to motivate you, inspire you, and push you to take action to finally go out there and achieve your dreams. Once again, I'm Jay Kalee, and this is the International Fitness Coach Living the Dream.
Ciao! We're here in Florence, Italy, at the Olympus Club with Fernando Liao. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great. It's so nice to have you here and showing you our programs, our gym, and it's so nice to have you here.
You know, I mean, Florence is beautiful. Don't get me wrong, Florence, the history here, there's a lot of great sights to see, but this gym has blown me away. You showed me around. There's what, 7 different levels, 5 different, I mean, how big is this place?
Yeah, we are quite big. Yeah. Actually, we are almost 20 years at the fitness industry, and we are doing our best. We have lots of types of activities, and we are trying to do our best.
Yeah, I mean, the amount of people I see here right now, I think you guys are outstanding. You guys are doing a great job. There's no doubt about it.
It's nice of you. I mean, we do our best. Let's say this.
It shows. So tell me a little bit more about you. What brought you here to Florence? What's the deal with you? Because you're originally from Brazil.
Yeah, I'm from Brazil. I was born in Brazil, and then when I was 24, I lived to Florence, and it was beautiful because at that time fitness was just at the beginning, and it was great to bring some new energy, and I was very accepted for the Italian people doing. At that time, we did a lot of step classes and conditional classes, and it was so aerobics, and it was going on at that time, and it was so beautiful here. We used to do classes at the parks, okay, at the squares, and it was quite a great time at the beginning. Now it's different. We're doing more with Pilates and more different things. In yoga, it's going great also here, but no, it's different. It's different.
It's a little different. It's been 20 years. A lot changes in the fitness industry in 20 years.
We've been changing also.
But it's good. I mean, you have to change with the times, no?
Sure. And the people, they want that changes. I have clients that they're working with me. It's already 25 years that they're working here at Olympus.
Wow.
Since beginning.
Wow.
So you need to change. And they're changing. They're accepting all that changes. And they're great also. I'm so proud of all of my clients. They do. We go crazy for each other.
Crazy for each other. I like that. You said that you actually do a lot of more like team building with your students also, or with your clients. It's not just come to the gym, do your exercises, and get out. You actually do more.
No. You know, working so far with them, they are not more clients. They are just like friends.
Absolutely.
And we do. Yeah, we have some very good friends. We do very nice parties. We used to do some hiking. So we go do some. Next month we are about to go to Sardinia with a group. Yeah, to cycling in Sardinia.
Wow.
And we have pedal here also. And so we try to take our clients not just for the gym, but I mean to the health in general. So they need to work out and they need to work out hard. But then we can have a lot of fun. We can have a lot of playing. We play tennis. We play paddle. We do a lot of things together, and this is beautiful because it's. I mean, they are not just clients. They are very good friends.
They almost become family almost. You, I mean, you care for them. You want to see them succeed.
That's it.
And I think that relationship is really huge. And I think in some gyms it's actually missing. You know, there's some places that you see a personal trainer so packed, they have so many clients. It's one comes in, kick him out. The next one comes in, kick him out. So you don't have that relationship anymore.
No, actually, now you know we met 25 years ago, and wonder who I'm training now. I'm training their kids.
Wow.
Yeah. Now their kids are our clients. So we are actually at the second generation of clients, and it is beautiful because they are trained together. So all the family together, and it's beautiful. It's beautiful.
You know, that another thing about that I really like is you're not just, like you said before, you're not just focused on the gym. You're actually focused on incorporating a lot of different things, just overall health, overall fitness. You're talking about yoga, Pilates, spinning. We got some guys almost look like they're doing parkour back here. They do a lot of rings and stuff. It's not just lift heavy and go home.
No. The thing about Olympus is that we go from 3 to 4 years old to 90 years old. From in that range, you can work at the swimming pool with the kids. We have classes of postural exercises for kids with postural problems. And then we have classes, aerobic classes, step classes for young people. We have weight training for men and or the people that want to work with weight training. And we have sports also. We have a soccer team. We have outside. It's from this year. And you go from the 2 or 3 years old kid from the 90, and we have such a good clients with 80, 90 years old that they're still here, they're still with us, and they're still doing a good job.
That's mind-blowing. That's mind-blowing. Honestly, I mean, get a little personal, right? My dad passed when he was 55 years old.
Terrible, man.
I mean, we all have our life to live, right? Yeah. So to hear that there's actually clients that are still training at 80, 90 years old, it almost reminds me of old school Jack LaLanne, right? I mean, that's awesome.
You know, we're in Italy, you know? And
we are in Italy.
Yeah, you guys know the Italian kitchen. We have such a good pasta. We have such good dishes, and we have every country has their own good kitchen, but I don't know, you guys, do you know Italy is pasta. The best pasta, like we say, mamma mia, it's so delicious. So it's just like the pleasure of having good things, just olive oil, and so healthy things.
Very, very
healthy things, because it's just like we don't eat too much. Sometimes we eat, actually, yesterday I ate some fried potatoes, but it's part of the culture. It's just like, it's us, and eating like that, living like that, because as I told you, we're not clients, and I'm not, it's not a relationship just like teacher and a client. It's our friend, it's our family, and we care about each other, and maybe you're thinking that's a paradise.
That is a paradise.
It is.
You get to have fun. You get to work hard and have fun. Work hard and have fun, and then you're with family.
It's even better.
So what got you into actually personal training and changing lives? What pushed you into this world?
I don't really know. I cannot answer. But it's like you just began to give people good habits, okay? And then someone asks you to just to be with them, and then you concentrate in that person or in something that they need to change. And then you began to work with personal training. I love to work with personal training, personal clients, just like one-to-one. But actually, we are a big group.
Yes.
Yeah, we are a big group. And it's lovely to work with 30, 40 people and all together having fun and smiling and kidding each other. And that's the best part. Yeah. So it's good also to, you know, it's different when you care about a personal client. When you change, I have a very good result with a manager. She works a lot. She works very hard. She travels all the world.
Wow.
And yeah, and then she called me and please come to me. And it's wonderful when you have this kind of people that can help them. Mm. And it's you know that yes. They just come to, oh, thanks so much. And it's we do, it's a job. It, you know, we do it as a job, but we love the thing that we that we do.
I love seeing the results.
Yeah,
the results in others, yeah. And how you can actually change lives, and like you say, create those good habits that they're able to pass on to their kids.
Oh, sure.
You know, it becomes a sure. You're changing more lives than just one at that point. You're changing kids' lives. You're changing the lives of their mothers, the lives of their sisters, and their brothers, and their friends also.
Yeah, we are doing like that.
It's almost like a scatter pattern. Like you get one, but it spreads out. And
yeah.
That's what I think is really beautiful about training or coaching or whatever. Not even just one-on-one. Like you're saying, even in group classes, it spreads. You know, and that drive, that energy, and that motivation is really fun to be a part of.
Sure, sure. It's just like that. It's just like being a whole family together. Two days ago, I was playing paddle.
Uh-huh.
It's the paddle. It's just like tennis and squash together.
Okay.
It's a mix between tennis and squash. And I was playing with a client,
mm-hmm.
and with my son and with his son. And
wow.
You know, just like 1 hour, 90 minutes, very tough because I don't want to lose.
Back and forth, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Competitive.
It is. It's beautiful. And you're just like having fun with your clients and your family at the same time.
Absolutely. So can you tell me a little bit, what was the biggest obstacle that you've had to overcome being a personal trainer? What was the hardest thing that you had to get through and that's helped you the most in your career also?
I don't know. Maybe it's to not know enough.
Mm.
It's great because sometimes you try, you know, you think that you know something, and then you try to help someone, and then you go to study and you realize that you don't know anything, and you need to keep studying, keeping knowing different things. And this is the challenge for me now, just like being informed about new programs, new protocols and different stuff, because we need to develop our skills also. And maybe this is the most difficult skill, because you need to teach, you need to have your personal life, but you need to study also. And we have back in the cameras a very good friend, and he gave me a very nice book, and I'm trying to Athletic in Sports.
Athletic in Sports.
It's beautiful. That's what I'm reading now.
Okay.
Athletic in different sports. And it's quite.
Give me the name, and I'll put it in the notes and stuff like that, so other people can see what
sure.
It is also.
It's in Italian, but I don't know. I think it's an Italian writer.
Okay.
But I'll give you after that.
Even better. I mean, who knows? Maybe they can get the rights and it's printed in English. Who knows? We don't know. Let's find out.
It's quite interesting, and I should counsel.
I mean, personal development is huge, and I think that you have to almost be one step constantly above your clients if you want to
sure.
continue to progress them. I mean, if you stayed the same how you were 20 years ago without actually improving yourself and improving your personal development, do you think that you'd be able to hold those clients for 20, 25 years?
No.
Absolutely not.
Absolutely not.
Yeah, we can't stay in the past and expect that we keep on reaping the benefits
yeah.
if we don't ever benefit and improve ourselves at the same time.
Sure.
So, yeah. How about the next question is, I have you, what's... Yeah, I know, I'm just going to pump them. This is a hard one. All right, I'm not gonna
go for it.
What would you say is maybe one of the biggest lessons that you learned from your mentor or someone that you look up to, like our gentleman behind us, right? What's one of the biggest lessons that you learned from him that helped you the most?
The lesson that I learned is that you don't know anything.
Same thing.
You don't know anything. You just okay, I've learned a lot because I've been at the fitness industry. I'm at the fitness industry for almost 30 years. Yeah, since my graduation. And then you think that you know something. Yep. Just like my master helps me like that. You need to keep studying.
So because
my mentors help us in that way. Say just like keep studying because you don't know anything already.
Yeah.
Yeah. So keep growing. Keep studying. Keep studying. Yeah.
Always study.
That's the thing that I learned from my friend. Actually, it's not my mentor, but he's my friend.
Yeah. Well, it's good to have good friends and mentors at the same time, right?
Yeah,
to have that relationship.
That's perfect.
You can learn from them, and even if it's a peer, or even if it's like someone who's older than you or in the business longer than you, it's always, you know, we don't know everything. We're pretty much reiterating what you keep on saying. We don't know. So it's nice to be able to even bounce ideas off of peers, too.
Uh-huh.
You know, you kind of push each other, and I think that's huge.
It is. It is. That's how you grow, actually.
So how would you say that you find that motivation to step out of your comfort zone? Because it's easy to stay in that comfort zone. It's easy to say, you know what? I'm good. I don't need to learn anything else. Why do I need to read another book?
The comfort zone is the problem.
It's easy to stay there, right?
Oh, it's that easy to stay there.
It could have been easy for you to stay in Brazil. You, if you think about it, Fernando stepped out of a lot of comfort zones.
Uh-huh. Yeah, you flew
halfway across the world.
Yeah.
I was in Florence, Italy.
I was quite comfortable.
And you're succeeding. That's the big thing I want to point out right now.
Uh-huh.
He stepped out of his comfort zone. He came to a country that he knew nothing about, really.
Nothing.
Did you know the language?
Nothing. No, actually, a friend of mine asked, do you know Florence? I said, Florence, where is it? And I'm living in Florence.
So what pushed you? What pushed you out of that comfort zone? Where did you find that motivation?
This is a big one.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm very curious. I'm very curious. I know you, and in my opinion, you are a spirit. So you are someone.
Thank you.
And it's very nice to know to have something from you that I didn't have it before, but now I have it. You know?
Yes, absolutely.
You know, that's so. I'm very curious to know people, to know different things, to know stuff, and maybe this is the answer for your question, to not be at the comfort zone, to be curious, to know different things, different people, because every person has one spirit, one experience, one background that you can give someone, you can share if you want to someone else. And I think this is the answer to your question. I'm curious about people. I want to know what you are, what you can give to me. A smile. That's beautiful.
Absolutely.
I don't need to know your name. I don't need to know all your family story. But if you give me a hug or if you give me something, your energy, that's it. And I think that's what keep me still, make me not be at the comfort zone, but try every time also to help people, but to try to know about different people.
Just constantly expanding yourself, you know.
I
think that you can. I'm a big believer that you can learn something from everybody.
It's
right.
It's there.
And then you take the good, whatever you want to hold on to, you hold it. And then
you
know, because we all have good habits and bad habits.
Yeah.
You take the good from that person, and then you can dispel the bad. You don't need to hold on to their bad.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Yeah. Sometimes it's easier to put it in different words or different perspective, right?
Yeah.
Like you know the saying YOLO. You only live once. Have you heard this before?
No. Oh, it's Tim again?
Okay, so there's a saying in America that's called YOLO. You only live once.
Y-O-L-O. Oh, never heard of it.
So usually, and most people hear it, they say YOLO, YOLO, as in let's do something dangerous or crazy or stupid. But you know what? I like saying, man, YOLO. You only live once, so why not be the best person you can be and learn from as many people as you can to become that better person? Because, you, like you said, you only have one spirit, you only have one experience, you only have one life. YOLO, right? YOLO. Yeah, yeah. So be your
YOLO,
best.
YOLO, just learn.
See, we always learn something
new. Yeah, I didn't know
always
about that
learn
before.
Something new. Is there anything else that you maybe want to tell other trainers out there? Maybe they're stuck, maybe they're in that comfort zone, maybe they're just going through the rigmarole, because we know we have a high turnover rate with personal trainers. Most personal trainers only last maybe 2 to 3 years, if that, because they either get burnt out, maybe they don't have enough clients and not enough students, maybe they don't know how to push themselves or step out of that comfort zone. So what would you say to some other personal trainer out there right now to help them?
I have a good one.
Okay, here we go. Let's hear this. I'm excited.
Yeah.
I'm excited because guess what? I'm learning something new too.
No, you know about that. It's called responsibility. Because when you prescribe exercise for someone, you're telling this person, do that. You need to be responsible for what you're saying.
Yes.
And so what I'm telling about people that want to go into the fitness industry, just be responsible. Because if you say, do a push-up or do a pull-up or do whatever you want, you need to be sure that that person is able to do it and know the technique, and it's good for this person's health.
Yes.
So
yes.
What I want to advise, if someone is at the beginning of the career, just be responsible, because this person trusting you, they're asking help. So it's just like if you are at the street and say, oh, in Florence, how can I get at the Duomo in Florence, and say, okay, go that way, and you need to be sure. I need to be sure that I'm sending you to the address that you want to go.
Absolutely.
So if you ask me for help, if you are asking me for benefits of the exercise, I need to be sure that this is good for your health. So this is responsibility, I should say, in one word.
And I know I love that, because I think that actually gets pushed to the side. We look at what's the new popular thing or what's new happening, and you know, we don't care if it's actually good for the student or good for the client or not. We just say, well, I've seen this on YouTube, or I've seen this during the CrossFit game. No, that doesn't work. And it also kind of goes back into the original point that you made for trainers of always pushing yourself to learn more.
Sure,
continuing education.
Sure.
Not just saying, well, I've seen this or I did this. You're actually continuing education because you want to bring that responsibility to people. That's awesome. I love that point. That's a
one of my masters taught me one thing, because maybe in Brazil fitness instructors didn't earn enough as they want, and he told me there's not a professional that earn
their degree,
but no, to earn money.
Oh, not
earn enough, not earn good money.
Okay. Or not make good money.
Okay. There's a professional that doesn't make good money. It's just a profession that are not good enough.
Mm.
So you need to be good enough to earn good money.
Ooh.
If you're not
another good one right there.
Yeah, but then it was perfect, because I said, okay, but fitness instructors don't earn enough, don't earn good money. And he said, no, that's not the the fitness instructors. There are lawyers that don't earn good money, that are teachers that don't earn good money. There a lot of categories that don't earn good money. But if you're good in what you're saying, what you are, if you are good in what you're doing, if you believe in what you're doing, you can have a good stability, and you can be happy. This is the most important thing.
I think so too. I also, there's a couple other things that I really love that you keep on talking about, this is a career. It's not a job, right? It's not just, this is a career. We've been in it for 30 years. There's people who've already retired after doing 20 years. You're still in this because you love what you do.
And I was 50.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It doesn't stop. I mean, if you continuously push yourself and you're good at what you do, you can do this for as long as you can.
Yeah.
I mean, for a lot longer
definitely, than definitely you can.
A lot longer than what a lot of other people can, and a lot of other different jobs too.
Sure.
And you take care of yourself while you're at it.
I need to lose some weight. I need to trust you.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm a little bit overweight, and to play tennis, I need to. And it's good. You know what? Because sometimes, like, as a trainer, you just say do that, and maybe when you have problems with when you have some food problems, just like you understand better your client, you know, it's like I know what's no, I don't need to eat it. I need to eat. I know that because I love to eat. Love to eat. And in Italy, it's so hard to do not eat. And if you eat too much, I feel fit.
Yep.
Okay, I can do weights. I have a good flexibility. I can work. I can play 2-3 hours of in a tennis court. Today I swam, and so I'm fit. But the problem here is to have food. It's too much food. I mean, it's too much good food. And this is good because you can understand when your clients say, "Oh, how can I do it?" And say, "Oh, I can understand you." But you know, we know all the problems of overweight, of bad habits, and good food and bad food. We know everything. We need to just to be set off to go to do the right thing.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. There's a good balance in there, right?
Yeah. You need. I mean, we need to live. We need to be happy. We need to. You cannot go for a table here in Italy and have some salad. You cannot. No way, man.
Yeah.
No, the
different types of pastas, spaghetti. I've never had food like I've had food here.
Did you gain the weight?
Probably, but I haven't even worked out. Look, we've been traveling. Maybe I haven't worked out. It's been almost a month now. I don't think I only come in gyms to talk to other trainers. I haven't actually trained at all.
Great.
Can you believe that? I can't believe that. I'm addicted to the gym.
Yeah.
But you know what? I've been doing a lot of walking too. So I feel like I almost lost weight.
Yeah. Probably lost some.
Just constantly walking and walking. But I can understand where if I was just sitting at home and didn't have any walking to do, if I already seen all the sights, I would easily gain weight. There's no question about it. So, Fernando, last question for you. Yeah. If people ever come to Florence, and I mean, they love your energy, they love how you are, they love how you talk and stuff like that, and your mentality, how can they find you? How can they get in contact with you?
You can find me at fernandoleao.com. It's fernandoleao.com. So it's my website. They can find me there. You can come to the gym. So write me, and it's gonna be a pleasure to receive you here. We have a lot of sports here. We have a beautiful place in Florence to do some sports and to relax also. And it's gonna be a pleasure to have you here.
Yeah, the Olympus Club here in Florence is honestly mind blowing. This place is beautiful. Meet up with Fernando.
Thank you so much.
You're not gonna be disappointed. I'm gonna put all of his links so it's easy to click and connect, and you can find out exactly how to get to him in your Facebook page.
Yeah,
you have Instagram
sure,
also.
Sure. I do.
So Instagram,
all
of it, I'm going to put all those links so it's easy for you to find. So if you come to Florence, meet with my man Fernando. You will not be disappointed, I promise. Fernando, thank you so much, man. This is great. I really enjoyed our time.
It was really nice to have you here.
Thank you. Ciao.
Bye-bye.